I'm Jenny Catul, Manager of Product Development for Sanderson Farms. Today I'm going to prepare herb roasted chicken. I have a 5-pound chicken. I've removed the giblets, I've rinsed it, and I've patted it dry. We're going to start by making a compound butter or a seasoned butter. I have 1 stick of softened butter, and to that I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of rosemary, 1 tablespoon of parsley, 1 teaspoon of thyme, and 2 cloves of garlic that I've chopped. I'm just going to mix this into a paste. I'm using unsalted butter so that I can control the amount of salt in my recipe. To this I'm going to add like 1/2 teaspoon of salt and about 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper. You know, you can use any combination of herbs that you like. I happen to like rosemary and it goes great with chicken. This is mixed into a paste. I'm going to get my chicken ready. I'm going to loosen the skin on the chicken. I'm just going to use my 2nd and 3rd fingers, take it over the breast and then over the drumsticks. Now I'm going to take my compound butter and I'm going to place it underneath the skin. I'm going to use my spoon to do that. You can use your hands if you like. I'm just going to take it over the breast and then put it over the drumsticks. So now that I've got my compound butter underneath the skin, I'm going to truss the drumsticks. I have a 24-inch piece of kitchen twine. I'm just going to wrap it around my drumsticks like so, and then I'm going to cross it, pull it tight one more time around, and tie it into a knot. Okay, now my chicken is nice and compact. My chicken wings are tucked so that when we roast them, they won't burn. So it's ready to go into the pan. My roasting pan is ready. I've sprayed it with vegetable spray. I'm going to line the bottom of the pan with onions. I've sliced them about 1 inch thick. This is going to give it some flavor. It'll also lift the chicken off of the bottom of the pan and help it to cook. I'm going to place it in the pan, breast side up. I'm going to add a little bit of salt and pepper to the top of the chicken. So now it's ready to go into a 375-degree oven for 1.5 hours. Our chicken's been cooking for 1.5 hours, so I believe it's ready. It smells good. I can really smell the rosemary. I like to check and make sure that my chicken is ready. I like to use a thermometer. It should read 170 degrees in the breast and 180 degrees in the thigh for a whole chicken. Not only is cooking a whole chicken economical, but it also makes a great presentation, as you can see. This recipe and others can be found here on our website at sandersonfarms.com.